black board mujira ina tafutri kwa sibira mke mukobeka.
Busoga sub-region has consistently performed poorly in national examinations over the years, and this has been blamed on many issues ranging from lack of committed leadership in the region to widespread poverty and cultural attitudes. In a bid to curb any further decline and improve education standards, leaders from Busoga region got together to form the Busoga Education Initiative. As part of the initiatives to improve education standards, over 400 teachers from the worst performing schools in the Busoga region are undergoing a retooling exercise in Jinja district. The exercise, which is conducted by commissioners from the Ministry of Education and other district leaders, is mainly focused on teaching methodology and leadership.
Because where leadership in a school is keen, absenteeism will be history. And where the teachers know what to do in terms of skills and methodology, the children will be able to be in school, the children will be able to read, the children will be able to understand.
According to the Busoga Education Initiative chairperson Agnes Kadama, efforts to revive the quality of education have already begun to bear fruits, as Kagogwa Primary School, one of the worst performing schools in the region, managed to get 4 first grades and 32 in second grade, something that hadn't happened in over 10 years.
When the school was the worst, we started talking so much about that school. We'd give that example all the time, that can you imagine you have 40 children and they all get zeros? But then because we kept on talking and giving that example, then they networked with this school here where we are, Viva College. And Viva College has helped it to come up very highly.
I'm almost 3 years old there, but when I was taken there, I was as if I was crying. From Nakanyonyi Primary School, a good school, to Nakagogwa, which was the last school in the whole country. So I felt, but this time I'm feeling, I don't know. Honestly, I cannot express myself because I'm extremely happy.
Despite all the efforts to revive the quality of education in the region, there is still a challenge of addressing the question of infrastructure.
Some of the biggest problems that we have are infrastructure. And infrastructure is a very, very expensive venture. If you want to put up schools and you want to put classrooms and to provide them with desks, you need money, which we don't have. And yet we see that our children are studying from under the tree. Some are seated on the ground. And when it rains, they don't study. Hence the reason you see them performing badly.
While speaking on the sidelines of the retouring exercise, the State Minister for Karamoja Affairs, Moses Luzige, partially attributed the deterioration of academic standards in some parts of Busoga region to poor leadership and the inconsistent voting patterns among the electorate.
They do vote with disgust and they vote out leaders, even if leaders are doing very well. There's no way I understand how 4 ministers lost elections. There's no way how 26 out of 35 members of parliament lost elections. It can't happen in any other region, solely in Busoga, where you have such a turnover of voters. So we need to do a little more. People should do, think more, should think beyond just what they see in political leaders.
He, however, appealed to the people of Busoga to be extremely cautious when voting leaders.
People like Honorable Kadaga. Honorable Kadaga first went to parliament in 1989. If you see what she's doing in Kamoli, because there has been a level of continuity, you can't see it. But now you are planning, like in 2005, when we adopted the district development pledge for Busoga, we were all voted out, except a few. We were all voted out, and it collapsed. Until we returned after 10 years, that's when we have the Prime Minister's office giving us money for a special program for Busoga. If we had not lost out, probably Busoga would be at a different stage now. So these are things the Busoga must start thinking about.
The Busoga Education Initiative was launched by the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, in November 2018, to improve the quality of education and mobilize resources to facilitate teaching, improve infrastructure, and generally create a conducive environment for learners in the region. Aaron Mukama, NTV.